to thank all the candidates for coming. We have two candidates not in the debate that I wanted to recognize. Hal Bennett's in the room, who's running for corner. Hal, will you stand up, please? And Mary Beth Pass is in the room. Mary Beth. We've got Mike Dudgeon and Jack Murphy in the back. And we will get started. The candidates are going to stay seated for time, so we won't be walking back and forth, and everyone has a mic in front of them. We've got a lot of questions to cover. We've taken a lot more questions tonight. Well, I don't know that we're going to be able to get to them all. Each candidate is going to have a two-minute opening statement and then a two-minute closing. We're going to do opening remarks alphabetically. So that means that Patrick Bell is up.
Thank you, Mr. President. First of all, I'd like to commend my opponents for stepping up to run for county commission, and I'd like to thank the Forsyth County Tea Party for hosting this debate. Being elected to serve as a county commissioner is one of the greatest honors of my life. During this campaign, I'm going to do my best to tell you why I should be reelected and not get into the mudslinging that's already begun. Why should I be reelected? I am the proven small government, pro-business, anti-tax commissioner that works every day to boldly represent the citizens of District 4 and all of Forsyth County. I've been one of the most, if not the most, pro-business commissioners this county has ever seen. While others were saying it couldn't be done, I pioneered the 400 North Opportunity Zone that has attracted private investment, created private sector jobs, and expanded the tax base of District 4. When one of our businesses lost a county contract to an out-of-county dealer for a matter of very few dollars, I champion the local small business initiative that allows us to favor local businesses and return tax dollars to our own small businesses, our citizens. When I ran for office, I promised to listen. As of this date, I've had 5 town hall meetings. When I promised to cut wasteful spending, and I've worked on the elimination of some $20 million from the county budget in the last 3 years. I promised to keep our taxes down, and I've done that. In 2009, there was tremendous pressure to vote for an increase, but I listened to you and steadfastly refused. As a result, there was no tax increase. In 2010, when a massive 1.6 mil tax increase was proposed, I fought vigorously and it was defeated. In 2001, I once again stood up against the tax increase, and you can count on me to do so again in 2012. You see, I've kept my promises to the citizens of Forsyth County to be a small government, pro-business, anti-tax commissioner. Now, some folks say I'm too combative, and to that, well, I plead guilty. But I've fought against some of those powerful special interest groups in this county. Thank you.
Next will be Jim Ball.
Thank you, first of all. Thank you all for coming. It's very nice to see such a large turnout. My name is Jim Boff. I am 60 years of age and have lived in the county about 19 years, serving on the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners for the last 3 years or so, and am retired. This year I was elected chairman by a majority of the board. I have worked hard over the last 3 years to be fair and open to all ideas, and have tried to make good decisions for the county. I have a special concern for homeowners because they are the backbone of the community and have been much abused by governments and some businesses in the last several years, and continue to be. My only goal is to remain your county commissioner. I have no aspirations for any other office at any other time. My focus is nearly entirely on the county. The nature of the questions tonight to me is unknown. However, should questions come up, I just want you to know that I will not generally answer questions about state or federal politics because that's not my focus, and I'm a county commissioner or running for one. But we'll endeavor to meaningfully answer questions which relate to Forsyth County. Thank you very much.
Next will be Dennis Brown.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dennis Brown. I'm running for candidate for commissioner in District 2. It's a pleasure to be here. Thanks to the Tea Party for hosting us. By the way, I'm the only candidate in District 2 who hasn't filed a complaint against you guys, so welcome any donations to help us beat the incumbent. I entered this race not to run against somebody, but to run for something. What I'm running for and what I will proudly stand up for is less government, less wasteful spending, lower taxes, greater transparency, and better ethics. Like most of you, I oppose SPLOST 7 and will oppose the transportation SPLOST. I also oppose a 15% share of the lost revenue for the city of Cumming. Well, I think that's way too much. What I will support is the fight to take control of county government out of the hands of the powerful special interest groups and put it back where it belongs with the citizens of this great county. Our citizens have been left out of the decision-making process long enough. It's time to chart a new course and take our government back. Just the last few minutes, I'll tell you, I'm a 30-year military veteran. I retired as a colonel after leaving Afghanistan in 2010. And it's been a great honor to serve the country, and I'd like to continue serving for four more years at the county level. I have a master's degree from Kennesaw University in international business and a HRM degree from the University of Alabama. I have experience managing multi-million dollar budgets, supervising personnel, rebuilding infrastructure, including the Corps of Engineers in Afghanistan, and a lot of the things that the commissioners have to do here. I'm married to my wonderful wife, Susie, and we're both active members of First Redeemer Church. Please visit my website, votedbrown.com. I appreciate your vote and your support and your prayers. Thank you.
Next is John Derucki.
Thank you. I might start out a little nervous, but I promise you I'll warm up before the night's over. I met most of you as you're coming in the back door. But to give you a little bit of background on me, I've lived in the county since 2001, and during that time I've had an opportunity to serve on a lot of nonprofit boards. Some of those are Leadership Forsyth, Chamber of Commerce, SAF, which is an organization near and dear to my heart, the Rotary Club of Forsyth, and Keep Forsyth County Beautiful. I'm also on the board of the Three Chimneys Homeowners Board. I have a Bachelor of Science from Purdue University and a Master's degree from Keller Graduate School. I too am a veteran of the U.S. Army. As a commercial general contractor, for the last 29 years, I've become a trained problem solver. As a business owner, I understand fiscal responsibility and know how to reduce costs without cutting services. I'm committed to sound principles of leadership focused on the future of this county. During this economic downturn, it's critical that the Board of Commissioners work to promote quality job growth within the county. I'm committed to help bring new business and to work with existing businesses to create jobs and maintain positive growth that is well planned and that will follow the county's development plan and codes. I'm committing to working with local organizations, local governments, and our schools to obtain mutual goals for our future. Finally, I understand that the major issues facing us today include solving some of our long-term problems. I'm sure we'll discuss those tonight. Some of those are water issues and traffic congestion. We need to immediately address these issues for the benefit of all county residents. These are some of the reasons that I believe that I will be an effective and responsive commissioner for District 5 and the county. I want the voters to know that my dedication to serve the people of the district and Forsyth County as a whole will always be strong and true in my heart. That is why I ask you for your support on July 31st. Thank you.
And since I forgot, will everyone please check your cell phones, make sure you have them on mute, and will all the candidates please put their cell phones up on the counter where we can all see them, where there won't be any text messages going on during the debate.
Hubbard.
Thank you, Steve.
I didn't mind the slip of the out of that. I'm Tim Hubbard, and I was...
Tim, you need to put your butt in front of you.
I'm awful new to this. Been a lifelong resident. Reason I'm running is I made excuses for several years, and I run out of excuses. I love Forsyth County. I've been here all my life. My father's been here all his life. My mother and my grandparents. And the county's been good to us. And I just want to see the same thing for my children, my grandchildren, and so on. And I know in order to do that, we need to keep a low tax base. And I realize spending is out of hand. It don't take very much to look out over the county and just drive through. You can. It don't take long to realize spending is out of hand. And I would like to just, with your support, and if elected, to try to work with people. I try to represent people. I just want to run the best servant of the people. This is what politics has got out of hand. We're supposed to serve the people. And that's what I look to do if elected, is try to serve the people and make sure that there's no big eyes or little U's, that everybody is looked at. And I know I'm not real good with computers, text messaging and all that, but I am good on the phone, and I am good to talk to people. And that's the way I'd like to be able to, if elected, is to talk to you one-on-one, not over a text message or an email. I know that's the way things are today, but I still like the old ways. And thank you very much.
Next is Charles Meagher.
Thank you, Steve. I'd like to thank the Tea Party for organizing this event. You did a great job with the sheriff's debate a month ago, and we look forward to this debate this evening. I am Charles Meagher. I'm running for the District 4 Commission seat. I've demonstrated leadership in a broad spectrum of endeavors. I'm a retired 39-year educator. I was a teacher, assistant principal, principal, and central office administrator. My last assignment was as the athletic director and the director of community schools and student activities for Gwinnett County Public Schools. Over those 39 years, I learned that an effective leader was the person who learned to listen and learned to respond to needs, the needs of those he represented. I have experience as an elected official. I've been involved in politics as far back as high school and college student government. I have proven electability. I was elected 2 terms of service to the Duluth City Council during the time when Duluth was touted as the fastest growing city and the fastest growing county in the nation. At the time, Duluth had about the same number of voters that District 4 does now. I believe in service. I believe in service to our nation, and I believe in service to our community. I currently serve on the county's tax board of tax assessors, and as you know, the board's purpose is to set value, not taxes. I'm a member of Coming First United Methodist Church, and I've served on the church's administrative board. I currently serve as a trustee for the chapel at Baldridge Arena, and the chapel services begin May 6th, and I'd love to see you down there. I'm retired from the Army National Guard after 23 years of service. Those of you who have served in the military or retired former military know their exceptional work ethic and loyalty and sense of duty. I hope you'll recognize those qualities in me over the coming weeks. Thanks.
Next is Cindy Mills.
Thank you. My name is Cindy Jones Mills, and I want to serve you as your next District 4 Commissioner. As I look back on the past almost 50 years of my life, I see a correlation between where I have placed my faith and the most significant events in my life. I see my daughters, and as I place my faith in them, I worked in their schools and coached them in youth athletics. I see my church, and I see the faith I put not only in God, but also in the youth I taught at camps, Bible study, and in Sunday school. I see my community and the faith that I placed in it by serving on many boards, park and recreation, chamber, chartering a Rotary Club, and creating the Gateway Opportunity Program for at-risk kids. Each of these actions that I have worked are reflective of the faith that I have in my fellow man and in my county. I strive to be an example to my children as my grandmother was to me. She walked 10 miles a week to teach school in a one-room schoolhouse for a dollar a day because she had a love of community, knew the value of education, and wanted to make her community better, and so do I. I watched our government up close for many years, and frankly, I've lost faith in the system. I've looked on as these supposed public servants serve their own special interests instead of the interests of the taxpayers. I've watched as they squander our money foolishly, betray our trust, and use their positions to improve their own personal lives and fortunes and not that of the citizens. A true leader doesn't resort to bullying, and a true leader knows you must show respect to your constituents and to your fellow board members in order to be effective. When your commission meetings begin to mimic a Jerry Springer show, you're in trouble, and I want it to stop. I'm not a politician, but I am a citizen that cares about our county. I want to restore my own faith in government, so I decided to follow my grandmother's footsteps and be the leader she taught me to be. Now I'm asking you to help me to realize that goal, to stand by me and to ask people to vote for me and to go vote yourself, and let's seize the opportunity and make me be your next District 4 commissioner. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Bill Mulrooney. My wife and I grew up in Gwinnett County, and we moved here in 2000. For anyone interested in learning more about me, please look at my website, BillMulrooney.com. More than anyone else here, I use my site as a place where people can learn my opinions and ideas on subjects that matter and affect our county. I constantly update my site, so please keep an eye on it through the entire campaign. There are three main points that I do want to stress tonight. First, the homeowners of District 4 need responsible and ethical representation on the Board of Commissioners. District 4 residents are pretty used to being treated with little respect or just outright ignored. That is going to change. With me as commissioner, the homeowners of District 4 will know that as their representative, I will be their champion. Second, we need responsible and intelligent growth. We have to get out of the mindset that we are simply a bedroom community and that retail equals economic growth. Retail is a byproduct of growth, it's not the creator of it. We need to take responsibility for our own future and bring real companies offering real wages to Forsyth County. Instead of planning around the idea that this is just a downturn in our economy, we need to realize that this is our economy. And as the old saying goes, hope for the best, but plan for the worst. And third, we need to be fiscally responsible. In the past decade, voters have approved $300 million in sales tax for capital improvement projects. The challenge the next board faces will be how to meet these goals and still keep spending down. It won't be easy, but I believe we can do it. Because quite frankly, we do not have a choice. Homeowners simply cannot afford to give up any more money. For tonight, I hope everybody just sits back and enjoys the show. My hope is that for most of you, this is just an introduction to me, and you will go to my website to learn more about me. Again, it's BillMulrooney.com, and thank you. Have a good night.
Debate is a very important part of our election process. It allows our citizens to get to be able to ask questions and to allow each candidate a chance to challenge others' answers and issues. If you are elected to be commissioner, do you feel that an elected official owes it to the citizens of our county and to your constituents to attend a debate during an election year? Or as an incumbent, would you not show up for the debate? If so, why?
Somehow, because that's not really addressed to me. I believe in openness. I believe that you should be present to present your views.
Brian, what do you think? Constituents, these are the people we're going to be working for, and I think it's an insult for you not to be here. Let me say that I think probably who's hosting the debate here has something to reason the incumbent's not here. Thank you.
I absolutely believe that you should be here. I mean, obviously, we're talking about the empty seat to my left.
Thank all of you for attending tonight. And we're going to start with Jim Boff
for the closing remarks, and we will continue to go in the same way that we've been going. Jim.
Thank you. I would just like to say that I'm the candidate here, one of them that has now got some experience under his belt. I have been reasonable. I have actually talked to my opponent back in the fall, who told me that he really didn't have anything that he didn't think I was doing at the time, but that he thought his leadership style was better than mine. So if you're going to be voting style points, I'll concede those to him. He's also made it sound as if we're about to run out of water because of some lack of something the board has or has not done, but at least this board has gotten the mayor to clearly say he will not turn off the water. I think that's a big step. It makes it clearer in my mind. Finally, my opponent has a business that he has to run. His general lack of attendance at most other kind of meetings, except for the town hall meeting about water, has been noticeable, and I don't think that that will improve if you were elected commissioner. So in a nutshell, what I'm saying is, if you're going to vote, please vote for experience, not Derucki.
Eight's enough. I'm for term limits. The incumbents had eight years. 8 years is enough. It's time for some new ideas. We need to get rid of the wasteful spending. We need to look at ways to lower taxes, or at least, like we said, maintain them. And give the perception that we have, not just perception, but actually follow through, that our ethics are above reproach, and that we have transparency in our government that we're always talking about. Taxes are continuous. We see what's happening in Washington. We don't need it here at the local level. Restoring America does not start in Washington, D.C. It starts right here in Forsyth County with we the people. I would ask for everyone's prayers and vote, and if elected, I will make a difference on this board. Thank you.
Last conversation I had with my wife before I decided to announce that I was going to run for county commissioner, she looked at me and she said, "Dear, do you think you can bite your tongue?" I said, "Yes." So tonight I'm going to go home and prove to her that I did that. So we're going to run a clean race. In fact, in the spirit of cleanliness, I invite you to join me at the Fowler Park at 9 o'clock on Saturday. Keep Forsyth County beautiful, clean America. So we'll set that as our theme, so I won't respond to the rookie comment. But in saying that, you know, I don't need to attend the meetings. In today's technology, I can watch it all on a computer from my office, where I can take nice, clean little notes and keep track of things. You know, I'm not a politician. I'm not looking for another title. The best title I ever had was when my kids were little and they looked at me and they called me dad. So to me, that's what it's all about. You know, I'm here because part of what I think is required of a county commissioner is selfless service. It's not the amount of time that you put into this or the time that you have available, it's the quality of time that you do that. And holding you people who haven't stepped on this side of the table near and dear to our heart, and remembering what those values that you were raised on, and bringing that to this board of commissioners. That's why I'm here. I mean, I get tired of the survival island. And when I look at the current board, and I'm not going to pick any one name now, I'm bothered by it. And that's why this room is full tonight. You folks are bothered by it, I'm willing to step up and do something about it. I'm going to work hard at it, and I hope that I get around and I knock on your door and I introduce you and I shake your hand and I tell you who I am and what I'm all about, because this is from the heart. That simple. Thank you, and I look forward to your support.
First of all, I'd like to just take this time to thank everyone who can participate. Like each one of the people that's here. And I'm a rookie. If I'm elected, I'll be a rookie. And I'm gonna mess up, I'm sure. But I'm not going to sit up here and tell you I'm perfect, because I am not. But I will listen to you. That's one thing you can ask anybody about that knows me. I will listen to you, and I will talk with you. And I am one that'll get in there. I'm bad, you know, I made some statements tonight that may blow some minds about going north. But we need to look at things. And if I'm wrong, okay, help me. Let's help one another, because this county water's going to be our main thing here in a few years, because we're getting to the point, there's a lot of population. And we need to always be concerned about water. I believe we've worried more about recreation than we have what we need, a source of water. Without water, we die. I mean, that's just the way it is, and everybody's going to start running out and drilling wells and whatnot. There's going to be a lot of people very upset, so we need to be thinking ahead. Not thinking and looking at right now, we need to think ahead. But if I'm elected, I'll do the best that I can to serve you. And to be a servant, that's the only reason I'm running, to be a servant of the people, and that's the way I look at it. I'll be here on account of you. I don't want to tie. Lord knows I don't want to tie. But I felt the need and the desire in my heart to pump myself out here for these. Not for a want, but for what I feel. And that's the way I feel tonight. Thank you.
Charles.
Thank you. I stand behind my record of leadership. I stand behind my record as a developed in my tour duty in the Duluth City Council. I stand behind my record of service, and I pledge to you that all that service would entail. And I truly do thank you for attending this meeting tonight. I look forward to meeting you. I look forward to working with you in the weeks ahead. Again, a special thanks to the Tea Party for having this event. Appreciate it.
Cindy?
I'd like to take this time to thank the Tea Party for having the event and for thanking all these gentlemen for stepping up to the plate and running for office. I believe that a lady will bring a new interest to the board that will represent a gender that needs to be represented. I feel like that I can bring something to this table from all of my past work experience. I think you can talk to anybody that's went to church with me, and they'll tell you I don't do anything halfway. I mean, if I do a job, I'm going to work hard at it, and I'm going to see it all the way through. I know it's going to be a challenging job. I know that we're going to have issues that are going to be tough ones to have to deal with just all with the money shortage, with everything that we're facing. But I feel like I'm up to the challenge, and that I have my heart's in the right place, and I'm doing it for the right reasons. My niece that's here tonight, Caroline, was in her eighth grade class recently, and they were discussing voting by district, and a young girl shouted out, I don't know what district I live in, but that lady named Cindy definitely lives in District 4. And I appreciated the fact that she had noticed my signs and that she saw and called attention that she knew that I lived in District 4, because it's something I have been so proud of. My entire life is where I come from. And I'm very proud of the district that my family's eight generations into that district. And it's something that I would serve that district with such pride. And I put my name big on the signs with Cindy because I wanted people to know that I'm just Cindy, and I'll always be just Cindy. And I'll be a person that you can call on that for help, for questions, and I'll just be a Cindy that you can trust. A lot of you here tonight are people that I know and love. I want to thank you the most for the way you've always loved me and for the way you're supporting me now. Together, I feel like we can restore our faith in government. Please vote for me, Cindy, on July 31st.
Bill?
Yes, indeed. That's what the Bill spell and Bill thing is really confusing. You know, I'll kind of comment on John here. My wife said the exact opposite thing. She said, quit complaining, get off the couch, and get out there and do something about it. Community service is a big aspect of our lives, and it has been since the day we moved in. My wife and I both volunteer a lot with a lot of different charities, and so on, board of directors, and go to my website, you can read all that.
But I'm a simple guy. I have a little 6/10 of an acre lot up in North Forsyth, right down the road from Lanier Land. I don't have any property under conservation use, never have. I am the only candidate, and I'm speaking strictly for District 4, I'm the only candidate who's filed a financial disclosure statement with the state. Now, this is something that has to be done by June, but you can do it on January 1st, because it tells things such as what LLCs your shareholders in, or what property you actually own. Because according to our tax records, 2 out of the 5 candidates for District 4 don't even own property in this county. I do. This is a very important place to live. I love it here. But you know, bottom line, I'm not the standard good old boy candidate. If you like the good old boy way of doing business, you got plenty of folks to choose from. That's not me. I'm here to represent the homeowners. I'm here to represent people who, just like me, just want to trust that their county is in safe hands, that somebody has their back, somebody's championing them, and they don't have to worry about getting steamrolled by their own government. Thank you.
And finally, Dr. Bell.
Thanks, Steve. Once again, thanks to the Forsyth County Tea Party for hosting this debate. Yesterday, after I got home from church, I was fiddling around the house and began thinking about this debate and the issues that we would like to hear. And something puzzled me. Take a moment to think about Forsyth County, if you would. Reality is, Forsyth County is a great place to live, work, and play. My opponents would like to paint a picture of gloom and doom, but don't let them put one over on you. Forsyth County is a great place and is in great shape. Think about it. Our departments are recognized nationally, regionally, and throughout the state. Our school system is one of the best, hands down. Forsyth County's been named as one of the best places to get ahead, among other prestigious honors. Financially, you couldn't ask for a better county. Forsyth County has the lowest millage rate in Metro Atlanta. I was on the Finance Committee when we eliminated nearly $20 million in operational expense. Forsyth County's received excellence awards for transparency in accounting and earned a AAA bond rating. It's not gloom and doom. Yeah, we still got work to do, but I'm proud of what's been accomplished since I've been on the board. This county is in great shape. No, it's not as bad as they'd like you to believe, but then again, they need a platform to be relevant and have attempted to create a reason for you to be unhappy. Why? They need you to be unhappy in order for them to get reelected. Ladies and gentlemen, this is no time for innuendo, rhetoric, sound bites. It's no time for inexperience. It's no time for bitterness about lost contracts. No time for personal agendas. No time for overwhelming conflicts. No time to stack the board with family and friends. And no time to try to buy a seat on this board of commissioners. It's certainly no time for quiet leadership. It's time to ensure you continue bold representation on the board. Time to continue shrinking government, continue eliminating government interference, and continue my initiatives to eliminate bureaucracy and continue to make Forsyth County a friendlier place to do business. Thank you for taking time out of your busy day to come tonight and for caring about our great county. I humbly ask for your support and would consider it an honor to receive your vote. Good night.
If you candidates want to go out and that way you can meet people as they're leaving, that might be a good idea. Thanks for coming, everyone. And yeah, please look around your seat. If you have any rides, we have a room in exactly the manner that we found it. Next month, we'll be here with the other space. Thank you.
I applaud the Tea Party for the way they've been sending people to watching, because it can make us all be better as public servants, the more people engage in the process and the more that they watch what's going on. It's a lot of money. It needs to be watched. And I think any time that you can, people know they're being watched, it's good. And that's why I started the Focus on Forsyth side when I did. And I just think that it's good for people to know what's going on.